Sunday. What a wonderful Sunday. It probably looks a lot different from both perspectives for the people that are here last week and for us who were at Mo Ranch last week. It's not 100 degrees like the young family said last week, but it's nice to be all back together. What a wonderful opportunity. And we've all come back together for a baptism. That's pretty special. And we're going to welcome some new members as well. So I thank you for all being here. And as we start our service, please turn in your hymnal to hymn 405 as we begin our divine service. Sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Let us then confess our sins to God, our Father.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in all word and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. as a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority. I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. The Kyrie today will be spoken. I know some of you, even though I ask if you have bulletin, it's a Lutheran church, I know you're not all going to tell me. We are on page 152 in the Cranberry book, if you want to follow along in the Cranberry hymnal. In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Amen.
The hymn of praise is printed in the bulletin, 547 in your in the Cranberry book, The Lamb. 547 in the Cranberry.
The The Old Testament reading comes from verses in Ecclesiastes 1 and chapter 2. I am vanity of vanities, says the preacher. Vanity of vanities. All is vanity. I, the preacher, have been king over Israel and Jerusalem, and I applied my heart to seek and to search out by wisdom all that is done under heaven. It is an unhappy business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. I have seen everything that is done under the sun, and behold, all is vanity and a striving after wind. I hated all my toil in which I toil under the sun, seeing that I must leave it to the man who will come after me, and who knows whether he will be wise or a fool. Yet he will be master of all for which I toil, and used my wisdom under the sun. This also is vanity. So I turned about and gave my heart up to despair over all the toil of my labors under the sun. Because sometimes a person who has toiled with wisdom and knowledge and skill must leave everything to be enjoyed by someone who did not toil for it. This also is vanity and a great evil. What has a man from all the toil and striving of heart with which he toils under the sun? For all his days are full of sorrow, and his work is a vexation. Even in the night his heart does not rest. This also is vanity. There is nothing better for a person than that he should eat and drink and find enjoyment in his toil. This also, I saw, is from the hand of God. For apart from him, who can eat or who can have enjoyment? For to the one who pleases him, God has given wisdom and knowledge and joy. But to the sinner, he has given the business of gathering and collecting, only to give to one who pleases God. This also is vanity and a striving after wind. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 100 responsively by verse. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth.
Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing.
Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name.
For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. The epistle comes from Colossians 3, verses 1 through 11. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you: sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming. In these you too once walked when you were living in them. But now you must put them all away: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and obscene talk from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have put off the old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. Here there is not Greek and Jew, circumcised and uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel. Chapter. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide the inheritance with me. But he said to him, Man, who made me a judge or arbitrator over you? And he said to them, Take care and be on your guard against all covetousness, for one's life does not consist in the abundance of his possessions. And he told them a parable, saying, The land of a rich man produced plentifully. And he thought to himself, What shall I do? For I have nowhere to store my crops. And he said, I will do this. I will tear down my barns and build larger ones. And there I will store all of my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, Soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, Fool, this night your soul is required of you, and the things you have prepared, whose will they be? So is the one who lays up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for the singing of hymn 592, Dearest Jesus, we are here. So I will keep it short. It's a wonderful text in which we see these people coming before Jesus and asking Jesus to make a decision on the inheritance. Now, some people would look at this and they would say, well, why would Jesus say, why am I your arbitrator? You're my God. But you have to remember back a couple of chapters where Jesus is talking about money when he says, give to Caesar what's Caesar's and give to God what's God. And there's a bigger point being made here. This person is worried about his inheritance over the very relationship with his brother. And if we look at those two things in contrast, we know where Jesus' heart is. Obviously, the man's relationship with his brother is much more important than any money that may be in a coffer somewhere. I see this quite often. I know many of you have seen this. Families can be wonderfully close and loving until someone with pocket change passes away. Then it becomes very difficult. Sometimes, for the rest of people's lives, they are angry and separated for just a few dollars. But Jesus is wanting us to point forward into the future, not only to what we have here, but to our heavenly crowns. Something that I remind you of quite often. When we do the works of the church here, we are giving of ourselves, but we are preparing more for us in heaven. I can think of no greater gift than when I am in heaven than being able to look back on this church and look at the pastors that will someday be preaching from this pulpit, or maybe it'll be a space pulpit, so it'll be kind of like hovering, I don't know. Whatever it is, though, I'll be looking at them and critiquing them, I'm sure. But I'll be proud of the fact that I played a part in helping make this church what it is, just as those sitting in the pews will be proud of what they are doing in this church to make it a beacon, a light on a hill for the rest of the world to see. You know, there's a big movement in Christianity, not just in Christianity, but really in society now, of people thinking they know when the end times are. It's huge. And I get this question almost more than anything now. People come up to me and they say, I've got it. I watched this person on Facebook and they know exactly when the end times are. I said, that's amazing, because Jesus said not even he knew. So I really want to meet this guy. And they say, well, you know, I put these together and I look at these numbers, and if you add these numbers up, and then if you transcribe this into, you know, Aramaic, and then you take that and turn it into numbers. And the truth is, none of it matters. Maybe he does know. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Because brothers and sisters, if I told you that the last day of this earth was going to be on August 24th, 2024, 100% for sure, that's the last day on earth, right? And you knew that, but today, when you left this parking lot, you got hit by a semi-truck, it wouldn't matter. Because you're going to see Jesus today. Today is your last day. So we don't know. And Jesus is reminding us here of this man who is storing all this stuff up and thinking, I'm going to be so happy now, sit back and eat, drink, and be merry because of all these things that I've acquired. And Jesus said, I require of your soul tonight. You neglected your relationship with me, and instead you focused on things that you will never have after this life. What are some of the things that we will never have after this life? What are some of the things that we should be focusing on? I need to hear this sermon, I think, more than anyone. But sometimes we do put our work and our own selfish desires over that of our family. Time will never get back. I wish that my children, some of them were still small enough that I could play another game of catch with a plastic ball or take them to do something that I think would be fun that they no longer think is fun. But those days are gone, and there's so many of those opportunities that I did miss because I thought I was doing the things that I should be doing, but I wish more than anything I could go back and capture one or two of them. So as we go forward, I try to remind myself of what's important. Even though I may be tired, or even though I may be upset or angry from work, or angry from the person who clearly doesn't know how to drive, driving next to me for the last 5 miles, or whatever the situation may be, right now I'm in the presence of my family, or I'm in my prayer time in the presence of my God, or I'm with my wife in a moment that we can be together. That's more precious than anything else here on earth. And I think if we take a moment and sit back, each of us will recognize that true sense. Quite often we're so worried about when is the end of the world? When is this? When is that? When is this? That we don't take a second and remember that right now I live in an air-conditioned home with food in my refrigerator. My family is here with me, and I have a moment to breathe. That's better than 99% of the entire history's life ever was. And yet we still find a way to be unhappy. Still find a way to be unhappy. Jesus says, don't worry about these things, these materialistic things that your heart desires and covets, because they'll steal from you the real treasures that I have set aside for you in life. Don't worry about these things that your eyes look at and you think, if I just had that, I'd be happy. Jesus is saying what that's stealing from you is the very things that I've already given to you, that if you use them and abide in them, happiness will overflow. Those are the things that not only will we have today and tomorrow, but we'll take with us when we go to heaven. Jesus says he gives us crowns that we will lay at his feet, and those crowns will be memorable. That I was a good father or husband. That I was a good steward of his church. That I did the things right even when no one was looking. That I did everything the right way even when I didn't want to sometimes. That doesn't mean we're not going to fail and fall down. Of course, we all are. But as Christians, the great thing is every single day, God gives us a new opportunity, a new chance to be new in our baptism, arisen again for another chance of getting it right this day. Today, we will witness two baptisms. Two beautiful, amazing souls will die to themselves and be risen with the Lord, brought into a family that will never abandon them. Brothers and sisters, you have that family. There's nothing in this world that is worth more than that. May the peace that passes all understanding be in your heart and mind. Amen. Please sing with me, all Christians who have been baptized, hymn 596. wonderful opportunity to see Riley and Molly be baptized. Please come forward. Riley, Molly, her parents, and her godparents. If you would please follow along in your cranberry books on page 268. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit." In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, "Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved." And the Apostle Peter has written, "Baptism now saves you." The Word of God also teaches that we are conceived and born sinful and under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the world, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. How are the girls named?
Molly and Riley.
Molly and Riley Gunter. Molly and Riley, receive the cross both on your forehead and on your heart. To mark you as one redeemed by Christ and crucified, let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemned the unbelieving world through the flood. Yet according to your great grace, you preserved the believing Noah and his family, eight souls in all. You drowned hard-hearted Pharaoh and all his hosts in the Red Sea, yet led your people, Israel, through the water on dry ground, foreshadowing this washing of your holy baptism. Through the baptism in the Jordan River, your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, you sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavish washing away of sin. We pray that you would hold Riley and Molly according to your boundless mercy and bless them with true faith by the Holy Spirit. That through this life-saving flood, all sin in them, which has been inherited from Adam, and which they themselves have committed since, would be drowned and die. Grant that they be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian Church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers, and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and a joyful hope, so that, with all believers in your promise, they would be declared worthy of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
From ancient times, the Church has observed the custom of appointing sponsors, godparents for the baptismal candidates and catechumens. In the Evangelical Lutheran Church, sponsors are to confess the faith expressed in the Apostles' Creed and taught in the Small Catechism. They are, wherever possible, to witness the baptism of those they sponsor, and are to pray for them, support them in their ongoing instruction and nurture in the Christian faith, encouraging them toward the faithful reception of the Lord's Supper. They are at all times to be good examples to them of holy life, of faith in Christ, and a love for thy neighbor. Is it your intention to serve Molly and Riley as sponsors in the Christian faith? God enable both of you to will and to do this faithful and loving work with his grace. Fulfill what we are unable to do.
Amen.
Hear the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. They brought young children to Jesus that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked those who brought them. And when Jesus saw it, he was greatly displeased and said to them, "Let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter it." And he took them up in his arms,
put his hands on them and bless them. This is the word of the Lord. Please pray with me as our Lord is taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Gunter family, do you renounce the devil?
Yes.
Do you renounce all his works?
Yes.
Do you renounce all his ways?
Yes.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth?
Yes.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried? He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead, he ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Yes, I believe.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting?
Yes.
Raleigh and Miley, do you desire to be baptized? Baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Almighty God and Father, Lord Jesus Christ, has given you the new birth of water and of the Spirit and has forgiven you all your sins, strengthened you with his grace to life everlasting. Receive these white garments to show that you have been clothed with the white robe of Christ's righteousness that cover all your sin. So shall you stand without fear before the judgment seat of Christ, to receive the inheritance prepared for you from the foundation of the world. You will receive the burning light, a light to show that you have received Christ, who is the light of the world. Live always in the light of Christ, and be ever watchful for his coming, that you may meet him with joy and enter with him into the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which shall have no end. In holy baptism, God the Father has made you members of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and heirs with us to all the treasures of heaven in the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We receive you in Jesus' name as our sisters in Christ, that together we might hear his word, receive his gifts, and proclaim the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Amen.
We welcome you in the name of the Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God and Father, we thank you and praise you that you graciously preserved and enlarged your family and have granted Riley and Molly the new birth of holy baptism and made them members of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and heirs of your heavenly kingdom. We humbly implore that as they now become members and your children, you would keep them in their baptismal grace and according to your good pleasure, they may faithfully grow to lead a good, godly life in the praise and honor of your holy name. And finally, with all your saints, obtain the promised inheritance in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
You may return to these saints. Well, this is definitely a time that we should clap in church. for Miley. Holly. Now let us stand together as we profess our faith together in unison in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated for our prayers. Almighty God, Holy Father, what a wonderful Sunday, what a wonderful blessing of the day to watch Molly and Riley be baptized into your name. Help us each to treasure the comfort and the love that you provide to each of us. Help each of us love and treasure the comforts of our spiritual family here at this church. Help each of us know the lives of the faithful people that are around us, that we too shall be one of them in this family, and help us to treasure in our hearts all that you do for us, even the things that we don't see. Enable us to show our thankfulness in lives that are wholly given to your service, Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Take from us all hatred and prejudice, Lord. Give us the spirit of love and order our days in your peace. Bring sanctification to our homes with your presence. Bless them with joy. Keep our children and grandchildren in the covenant of their baptism and enable their parents to bring them up in a spirit of affection and service. Be with those farmers and ranchers who desperately need rain. Calm their hearts in this time of trouble and be with them as we know all things work to your good to glorify you. Remember those with thanksgiving that we have loved and lost. Lord, in your mercy, we now pray for those whom you have put in our hearts in silence. We pray for Lisa and Forrest, Francis, Cody and Kayla, Jericho, Brenda, Bethany, Brad, Jacob, Harold, Vivian, Scott, Earl, Jackson, Margaret, Morris, PJ, Jimmy, Mark, Susan, Terry, Steve, Davina, Dave, Margie, Kim, Bonnie, Betty, Karen, Glenda, and Lane. We pray a prayer of protection over Daniel, Kurt, Ray, Anna, and Nathan as they serve in our national defense. Lord, in your mercy, all these things and whatever else you know that we need, grant us, Father, for the sake of him who died and rose and now lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Well, we're going to share the peace. Some people may not want to share the peace still. So if someone's just sitting down, let them sit down. Maybe give them a wave. But if someone gets up, that's on them. So give them a hug and a handshake and whatever else. The Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
We now share the peace.
Thank you.
Cup will come by first, and just let that go past, and then I will bring the common cup to you. All are welcome to the table of the Lord here at New Hope Lutheran Church. All are welcome. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
thank you.
Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and in the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and to drink his blood as he bids us do in his own testament. And gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayer. Deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory and honor and worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, given for you. This do in remembrance of me." The same way, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. As often as we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Amen. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, in giving us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom, but we have already prayed your prayer in baptism. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Depart in peace.
Amen.
Please come forward. The table is open.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen. body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in body and soul to life everlasting. Depart in peace. Baptism. If you've not been baptized and you wish to be baptized, please come and see me. Other than that, in a moment after the service, we are going to have new members come up. The sad thing about that is the wooden boards are off the hook already. We don't have to call them the new guys anymore. They just joined. It's sad. Well, we have a wonderful Sunday. If you don't feel good leaving the service today, I don't know. Come talk to me. I'll try to figure something. Give me something. A lollipop. I don't know. This is good. Today is good. This feels good. Please, when we leave today, there is a video in the back of Mo Ranch for the young families that went. Please go into the fellowship hall and see that. I think there's a couple of donuts left as well. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. We are going to sing 344 for our closing hymn, but you know what that means? We need our heavenly band. So if you are a young child or young at heart, please go get an instrument. We got a brat, we got a mad dash. I like it. And come on back up here with the instrument. Everyone else turn to 344. 344 on the joint bends the back of the drive. Morris, that doesn't mean you have to cry. It doesn't mean you have to cry. It's just the title of the hymn. Come on, guys. Come on up front. Come on up front. Okay.